Already existing pictures, and since everybody sort of knows what we look like, we thought it might be nice for people to see what we look like when we were so cute and unspoiled.
And you sure are cute and unspoiled in these photos. How did the first CD come about? Who got together and said, let's do this?
We met sort of individually. I met Dolly on the Grand Ole Opry show, and Emmy had met her.
And Linda and I knew each other.
And when we met, we said, who's singing do you like? And we said, Dolly's. And then Emmy had Dolly at her house, I think.
Right. I had Dolly. Dolly came to visit me in L.A. after I met her in Nashville. And I called Linda up and said, Dolly's coming to my house. You have to come over.
I don't think I even started to put my shoes on.
Really?
And the first thing we did pretty much after just saying hi is sit down and sing. And it just was a glorious sound. And we loved the sound of it, and we knew that we wanted to make a record.
Did you argue about which songs to put on it?
No, we didn't argue. No. We just had, Emmy finds all these great songs.
The best songs.
So we just kind of all get together.
We would just vote on them, which ones we wanted to do and which ones shimmered with the trio, because there are a lot of great songs that don't necessarily work in the context as a trio vehicle.
Yeah. We have a clip from 1977.
Yeah, this is about when we first started, long before the other trio album. Right. This is when we decided we had to do something together. We all looked pretty cute and funny.
All right, take a look right here.
Especially funny.
Hey, song,
oh, look at funny, and people sometimes say this of me, but I still think it of you. I think you guys are all friends. Like, I think I would Saturday night, right now the three of you are playing canasta. You know what I mean? Like, it would never occur to me that you didn't know each other beforehand. You know what I mean? Isn't that weird? People assume that music
brings people together.
I think there's a thing about being girl singers on the road, too. Like, you and I are single mothers. There's a thing you know. And I think there's a real sisterhood there.
Yeah, I agree. How are your babies?
They're great.
Are they great?
They're great.
Yeah, you're loving the motherhood thing as much as me?
I love it, but God, when I see other single mothers that don't have the kind of help and support that I have, I feel like I want to get down to my knees on them. You know, I have help and it's still so overwhelming.
Exactly.
And I'm just humbled by it.
Yeah, because people say to me all the time, Rosie, how do you do it? It's easy for me to do it because I have money, I have help. Right. It's how do the people do it who are really doing it?
You've got to find other people that know the way. I feel the same way about the Girl Singer thing. I always say, in Girl Singers Anonymous, I have Rosemary Clooney to be my sponsor because she's been down all the roads and all the side trails. You got to get somebody that's gone before you that knows, and you got to stay on the phone with them. And what do I do now? What do I do? She gave me advice about motherhood and singing, but don't you feel that way, that once you've been on the road and that's what you do, other people that have shared that experience become the wisdom that you seek.
Do you have somebody like that who you call up for advice or who you looked up to when you were growing and thought, that's who I want to be like?
Well, I actually have all that within my family because I have five beautiful sisters and my mom and my grandma, so I had all the advice I could handle.
Right. You had too much advice.
There's 12 kids and there's 8 younger than me, so I grew up with bunches of kids all the time. But she was talking about us being friends and getting together on Saturday nights. We really are good friends, and we do have a good time when we do get the opportunity to work together. And in the studio, we find time for a little fun stuff backstage. But I wish we all did have time, more time to spend together as girls and women and talk about our kids. And
have you all been to Dollywood?
Well, actually, I've played Dollywood, and I've eaten at Aunt Granny's.
That's a restaurant there on the grounds, Aunt Granny's restaurant. That's what all my nieces and nephews call me, is Aunt Granny.
Right.
Because, like I say, I don't have children of my own, but I'm everybody's mama.
Yeah. I was going to say, you do not look like a grandmother, Dolly. I don't know where they get Granny in there.
I don't feel like one, but I love the kids. I make a good aunt. I've probably been a terrible mother, though. God knows
what he's
doing.
You think you would have been a terrible mother?
I don't know. We'll never know, will we?
No, but why would you think that?
I'm too old to start now.
Would you think he just wouldn't have what?
Well, I don't know. I've been pregnant. I used to want children when I was younger.
Right.
Now that I'm older, I feel like, like I say, God has his plans, and he needed me to help with a lot of other folks' kids, I think.
Yeah, I bet you would have been a great mother. I think you would have been a great mother, too.
I guess
you're very warm.
Well, I would have been a friendly mother.
Yeah.
I'd have probably not been a good one. I'd have let him do everything I do, and that would have been awful.
How are your kids?
My kids are great, but they're 28 and 19, so they're off on their own roads.
You know? Yeah, are they performing? Are they?
Well, I have my oldest daughter is studying graphic design. She's into the art thing, and then my youngest is interning at DreamWorks in Los Angeles, and she writes songs and does just about everything.
She writes wonderful songs.
Really?
She kind of left the nest early. She left a year early out of high school. Right. She was ready to leave Dodge and went to L.A.
But she's doing well.
She's doing well.
It's a good ending to that story. Well, we're going to force you to sign many, many things. Dolly, I have one of your dolls in my collection. You signed the leg.
Yes, you signed the other leg.
Exactly. And we're going to put that up on eBay. We have all of my own personal albums of you guys, and we're going to have you sign them, and Emmylou gave me the pick, and the trio. Just go on ebay.com. We'll raise a lot of money for charity. I thank you guys so much.
Well, thank you.
I'm so happy that you did another CD. Trio 2, go buy it. We'll be right back with our final check-in at the Banadana Party. And they're also going to go, Al and Arlene, on an 8-day, 7-night cruise on Premier Cruise Lines.
Get on!